teams with their eyes on the top of the Big East standings meet tonight inside the Carrier Dome. It's the basketball feast we like to call Big Monday, presented by Bud Light on this Valentine's Day from Syracuse, where they love their number 9 orange. Tonight, Syracuse plays the playing host to the 15th ranked Panthers of Pittsburgh. They come in at 17-4. Both teams in pursuit of the first place Boston College Eagles in the Big East Conference. BC with a half game lead over Syracuse. The Eagles and Orange meet on Saturday in Chestnut Hill. Pittsburgh right now in a tie for fourth, but very much alive in their quest for their fourth Big East regular season title in a row. Good evening, everybody. Happy Valentine's Day. Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, and Bill Raftery. Delighted to have you with us. The homestanding Orange Jay come into this one off a big win, 15-point victory at Villanova Saturday.
Well, I think the key, Sean, is they're competing for a championship, as you mentioned, trying to keep pace with Boston College for the Big East regular season title. And if they are going to win that, they're going to have to do it behind the great play of Hakeem Warrick and Jerry McNamara. Mr. Inside and Mr. Outside both played extraordinarily well against Villanova. McNamara coming off after a poor outing for him against UConn, really bounced back, took good shots, and Warrick was unstoppable inside.
Meanwhile, Pittsburgh is hot. They've won 5 of their last 6. The only loss in that stretch was in overtime to West Virginia, and as usual, they're getting it done with defense.
To beat Syracuse, you got to beat our zone. And who better than Carl Krauser to light it up? 9 assists in this last ball game. Excellent passer, penetration, will do a lot of screening for him. And of course, Chevy Troutman, who can load it up on the block, high percentage shooter, and a toughness typical of Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh won that last meeting earlier this season on January 29th against the Orange. They won 76-69 on their home court. The starting lineups brought to you by Mazda. For the Panthers, Carl Krauser with Antonio Graves, Levon Kendall, Siobhan Troutman, and Chris Taft. And for Syracuse, Jerry McNamara with Billy Edelin making just his second start of the year. Josh Pace, Hakeem Warrick, and as usual, Craig Forth. Fourth starting his 128th straight game tonight. The Loud House in Syracuse, another big crowd here. There's Forth, the longest current active starting streak in Division I basketball, extended tonight. Hakeem Warrick controlled the tip for the Orange.
And Sean McDonough and Jay Billis. Pittsburgh goes.
Forth, now Josh Pace and Warrick, who's been on a tear of late. He had a career-high 32 in their win Saturday at Villanova in front of his hometown friends and relatives. He's from Philadelphia. McNamara hits a runner.
Syracuse so good at those dribble handoffs and setting a little screen, and you've got to step in hard as a big guy to try to stop that. Very difficult going big on little.
Big thing for McNamara is to stay fresh. Fatigue a problem that Saturday to Monday game. Plays so many minutes.
Jim Boeheim telling us before the game tonight, he thinks it's particularly a problem for McNamara. Generally very fatigued on those quick turnaround games. And a turnover as they could not find Levon Kendall in the corner. Jim Boeheim, a win tonight would get him within 1 of 700 for his career. This is his 27th 20-win season. And this is 29th year as head coach of his alma mater.
He's got to learn to relax before a game, doesn't he?
He's wild. He's in the hockey strike he's involved in. And there's a walk here. That's a tough call. Nice rebound by Taft. You know, Jay, it's really important, I think, how they play the ball screen, Pittsburgh, and how they cover in the back, is that when they screen and roll to the rim, there is a player available.
Well, guard on guard, you can switch, but they've got to step in hard with those big guys. Pittsburgh does such a good job of bumping cutters. And boy, if Hakeem Warrick is making that shot, it is going to be a long night for Pittsburgh.
Wow.
Well, he has scored 20 or more in 7 of the last 8 games. He had 25 in Syracuse's loss at Pittsburgh in late January. Taft the miss, and the rebound down to Billy Edelin. Minute and a half in, 4-0 Syracuse. Edelin left alone, missed a long two when Krauser looks to run in transition. That's a long two. Tapped out by Troutman to Krauser.
They had both big guys at the rim.
That's a three for Pittsburgh, and the Panthers are on the board.
You know, Billy Edlin, I thought, took a bad shot down there. And anytime you take a bad shot, that is essentially the first pass in your opponent's fast break. And Syracuse never got comfortable and never got back defensively.
Nice dish.
And Warwick couldn't quite reach for the dunk, but did drop it into the bucket. And a 6-3 margin for the Orange.
Now, Jay mentioned the handoff outside with a slap back pass for the jumper. He's great at drawing the D and then giving it to the bigs.
Krauser, he had 19 in the first game against Syracuse, 9 assists and 6 rebounds, played all 40 minutes. Jim Boeheim said he thinks Krauser's the barometer for Pittsburgh. When he plays well, they're almost impossible to beat. Graves buries a three. A couple of three balls for the Panthers. They're tied at 6.
Very nice ball movement, getting it from side to side. And Pittsburgh does a nice job of screening the zone and also getting into gaps, whether it's by the pass or the dribble.
And a much improved three-point shooting team. 41% this year for Pittsburgh from beyond the arc. That leads the Big East. It's 9th in the nation after they were 32% from 3 last year. Warwick was fouled.
Hakeem Warwick likes to face up, and when he does, he likes to spin on you. That is a really tough shot. He tends to fade away on his jumper, but boy, can he score, and he was magnificent against Villanova on Saturday.
And the length is incredible, too. It's very tough to block his shot. Look at this Globy move. Send it in, huh?
Everything but the bucket. The last foul for Pittsburgh was on Chris Taft, his first. Oh, tough. Krauser had it roll off. Fourth controls. Numbers for Syracuse on the break, 3-on-2. And a terrible pass by Edelin. Pace able to, not able to save it. Almost did, but stepped on the sideline. Pittsburgh is coached by Jamie Dixon. Not a bad start in nearly 2 full seasons now. 48-9. This head coaching thing's easy.
That's a snap.
4 years as an assistant at Pitt.
That's why he looks so young.
39 years old, a Southern California native. Krauser has another one roll out. Taft there. And that gives Chris more points than he had in the entire game. Against Notre Dame Saturday, he scored 1 point. He was benched for all but 4 minutes of the second half by Coach Dixon.
Yeah, this Pittsburgh team is so confident against a zone. Jay mentioned the screening. They flashed. They do a wonderful job with post rubs.
But when they screen the top of that zone, that means Craig Forrest got to come up and help, and that leaves the boards wide open.
And leaning in, looking for contact. Didn't get a whistle, but did get the bucket. And we're tied at 8, just more than 4 minutes gone by.
He and Pace do a great job of body searching and then finishing. Great medium game.
And they both have a knack for getting shots up over bigger defenders.
Brisk ball movement by Pittsburgh, and Siobhan Troutman is fouled.
Heck of a catch as well there, Sean.
Foul on McNamara, his first.
And Pittsburgh with the screen up top, the miss, and the boards wide open for Chris Taft, one of the best offensive rebounders in the Big East. Pittsburgh and Syracuse tied.
The NCAA Women's Basketball Championship begins March 19th.
Wow. Here's your Bud Light.
Thank you.
You know, I think I'm just going to go freshen up a bit, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Look at that.
I think it's so funny that you like to dance as much as I like to dance.
Hey. Yeah, well, she's a little annoying, but I'm desperate. Oh, gotta go.
Oh, did you meet Coop?
Coop?
She's annoying, but I'm desperate. She's annoying, but I'm desperate.
What's that all about?
Fresh, smooth, real Bud Light.
Nice try, pretty boy.
It's all here. Zoom, zoom, zoom.
Zoom, zoom, zoom. I think this could be a problem.
I think this could be a big problem.
I think we should drive that bad boy.
You know, for research.
Research.
Lease a 2005 Mazda 6i Sport Sedan for $199 per month for 42 months with $19.99 due at lease signing. Do a little research of your own. Get to your Mazda dealer for a test drive now.
I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts, bare man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
This spring, you don't have to go far to make travel rewarding. Just visit choicehotels.com and book a stay at any of these hotels. You'll earn triple choice privileges points or triple airline miles.
I've been everywhere.
Triple your rewards. Only at choicehotels.com. Choice Hotels. We'll see you there.
Tied at 8, nearly 4.5 minutes gone by here at the Carrier Dome. This is the second and final meeting of the regular season between Pittsburgh and Syracuse. The last meeting 16 days ago at the Peterson Event Center. Syracuse raced out to a 17-point lead. They led 22-5, but Chevy Troutman and Carl Krauser led the Panthers back from the 17-point deficit. Panthers had just defeated UConn a week before. Tail of two halves. Syracuse shot well in the first half, but Pittsburgh shot 50% in the second half to finish off the comeback. All 19 points for Krauser in the second half. Of course, in that Connecticut game, it was also a 17-point deficit that Pitt overcame.
I think of Rutgers when we were down there. That was unbelievable. So, were you amazed at the adulation that Jim Boeheim gave to Pittsburgh?
He said to us as we visited with him today before the game, he thinks Pittsburgh is the best team in this league.
Mm. Of course, he said that last week about Connecticut.
Syracuse was the preseason pick to win the Big East in the coaches poll. Connecticut second and Pittsburgh third. Siobhan Troutman shooting 59% from the floor and 64% for his career. So that 59% is actually down a little bit. 71% from the line. He makes one out of two to give Pittsburgh its second lead.
You know, I thought Pittsburgh's season really turned around a bit in the second half of that UConn game, and Troutman was the guy that did a little 2-3 zone now for Pittsburgh.
Ronald Ramon has come in, as has Aaron Gray, a couple of subs for Pitt. McNamara's shot rattled out, fourth attempt that wouldn't go. And it's controlled by Troutman.
That fourth did a nice job that time getting to McNamara for the easy look.
You know, McNamara was fading on that shot a little bit, didn't go straight up and down.
Ramon's three hit the rim and came out. And it's last touch by Syracuse.
Little instant offense when Ronald gets in the game. Good open shooter, can put it on the deck.
What I like about
8 points per game as their sixth man. He's a freshman.
He's poised, isn't he?
Very much so. Very confident. Of course, the genes are good, right? The dad was a great player. We mentioned that last time.
Yeah, Ricardo Ramon played professionally in the Dominican Republic, Brazil, and Argentina. And Ramon was really a spark off the bench Saturday in their win over the Irish. Three three-point field goals among the 13 points.
Pittsburgh screens in the zone as much as they do in man.
Boy, Gray does a nice job. He can make that shot, too. He's really stepped up his game. That's great basketball. Drive, draw, and kick it.
Ramon's three wouldn't go. Last touch by Syracuse again.
Jay had mentioned about screening the zone. They run a lot of things. They hit the gap, get into the middle, not afraid to give the ball to the wing. Guys can make shots. So many different looks they present. Once you take one away, Pitt comes back with another.
Levon Kendall, a three for his first points for the sophomore from Vancouver, British Columbia. Just his 10th three of the year, but like many of his teammates, he's an accurate three-point shooter at 41%.
You know, with this lineup, it almost is imperative to play zone, I think, for Pitt. They can't match up with the three bigs on the three little guys on the perimeter.
Plus, it gives them a different look. But I'll tell you, Syracuse had better start rebounding better out of this zone. They are giving Pittsburgh way too many second chances.
Rebounds are 9-3 in favor of Pittsburgh. Louis McCroskey, who was a starter until Billy Edelin moved in for the starting lineup in the last game, is off the bench. That rebounding has led to those 8 second chance points, 8 of the 12 for Pittsburgh, with an extra opportunity of 4 offensive rebounds to none for the Orange.
Roberts in the middle, very active. They might get some runouts with a shot block with the two bigs. And
Ramon, another miss. The rims haven't been very kind to either team so far here in the first 6 minutes.
Boy, Troutman is impressive. I mean, doesn't leap quickly, but gets it done.
Kendall a little bit out of control on the baseline, and Pace stole it. The senior hands off to McNamara. Perhaps that's what Jim Boeheim was talking about. The shooting legs sometimes aren't there for McNamara in these Mondays after a Saturday.
Had a little bit of a rush on the last one, too. Look at him search the body there, Jay. So impressive, strong, seeks out the opponent, and then he initiates the blow.
Such a smart player, plays angles well. He went after that ball, but then the nice pump fake, and you're right, Bill. He just seeks out that contact, and that's what a senior big guy does. He knows how to get fouled or score and get fouled.
He was a big part of that comeback
in the second half against Syracuse. Six straight games in double figures for Troutman. Demetrius Nichols in for Syracuse. Kendall goes out for Pittsburgh. Keith Benjamin, who played a big part in their win over Syracuse, is also off the bench.
This may be Gray.
No, they're going to give a lane violation on Warrick, I believe.
You know, the thing about Troutman, the non-Big East games, he was 13-6. The Big East games, he's 16.5. He just loves big situations.
And over the last six games, he's averaged 19.7 points per game. Gets another crack at the free throw and makes it. Curtis Shaw with John Clogarty and Tom Lopes are the officials here tonight. After a quick start for Syracuse, they've gone cold. McCroskey.
They don't have a real penetrator other than McNamara here, so it's going to have to be done by the pass and the cut.
They've got a couple guys that can extend the defense here, and Nichols is one of them, a terrific shooter.
And his first shot of the night way off. Nichols has been on the milk carton lately for Syracuse. He hasn't played in the last two games after starting earlier in the year. Jim Boeheim thinks he's better as a starter. He said a lot of times coming off the bench, if he misses that first shot, he feels like he might come right back out of the ball game. It's a confidence issue with him.
Yeah, a lot of guys feel better about themselves if they're starters, and tougher coming off the bench.
Didn't have to save it. It was going to be their ball.
Benjamin tried to throw it off McNamara. Hit his leg. He dumps it for Roberts for the dunk.
We know Roberts can run, but Jerry Mack just sealed the deal by taking his guy to the rim. Real good shooters on the perimeter here with Benjamin, Krauser, and Ronald.
Benjamin drove to the elbow and missed, and Warrick has the rebound. McCroskey, strong drive and the finish. Roberts almost tipped that in for an offensive goaltend. Fortunately for Syracuse, he didn't touch it, and Jamie Dixon calls a mini timeout.
Well, the one thing about the 2-3 zone, Jay and Sean, over the years, they face out, and frequently on their own merits, they get easy runouts. But generally, it's a rebound play, it's a hustle play, it's a trap in the corner. I just love what McNamara does here, Jay. Takes the D with him, and Roberts sends it in.
Well, he had Ramon in retreat, and on this next play, McCroskey taking it to the basket. Gray unable to recover, and I thought that Roberts actually touched that ball when it was live action. Apparently not from our angles.
Big Monday continues on ESPN, presented by Bud Light. Number 2 Kansas taking on Texas Tech. That's at 9 Eastern time. Then at midnight, it's the Mountain West battle between Air Force and New Mexico. Air Force, great defensive team, and New Mexico, a high-scoring club. McNamara dumps it off to McCroskey, who ties the game with the layup.
Off the timeout, they go right to the trap. We saw this against Rutgers. McNamara got away with a foul, I thought, Jay.
And Syracuse so much better in this full court trap when Hakeem Warrick plays the front, when he comes with those long arms.
Can't see anything, right?
A lot of deflections as well.
Out of bounds, last touch by Nichols. Syracuse has come from 6 down to tie it at 14.
I think this could be a problem.
I think this could be a big problem.
I think we should drive that bad boy.
For research.
Research.
Lease a 2005 Mazda 6i sports sedan for $199 per month for 42 months with $19.99 due at lease signing. Do a little research of your own. Get to your Mazda dealer for a test drive now.
There are riding mowers, and then there's the edge cutting system. Only John Deere gives you the edge. With dependability beneath you and your John Deere dealer behind you, you'll always have a John Deere yard to look forward to. Own a John Deere now starting at $14.99. Nothing runs like a deer.
Coney and Tots. Sonic's got it, others don't. Satisfy your Sonic cravings with our famous extra long cheese Coney, plus a large order of crispy tater tots, made fresh and served up fast, and now only $2.99. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
Being able to track packages is critical to our customers. That's why we've developed a more advanced scanning system. You see, we take delivering information as seriously as delivering packages.
UPS, what can Brown do for you?
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. And in part by Mazda, always the soul of a sports car. And Comfort Inn, new face, same friendly place. Visit choicehotels.com to book.
Six unanswered points for Syracuse to tie Pittsburgh at 14 apiece, and the press helping them get back even with the Panthers.
When Syracuse presses full court in their man-to-man defense with the trap of the first pass, they are long, they are active, and they are very hard to beat. You can see the trap on the first pass. Chevy Trotman tries to split it. He loses the ball, and McNamara winds up feeding McCroskey for the easy finish with the left hand.
It sort of gets the house into the game as well. I mean, they really turn it up a notch. You need easy baskets in a conference like this.
Another big crowd in here. You saw the configuration in the football arena. We're basically one end zone of the football setup. They move the stands from the far end of the football field to form the sideline from the angle at which you're looking down from the camera position.
You know why this press is so good? Pittsburgh wants to be a methodical team. They want to walk it up and pound you. And Syracuse can speed them up this way. Speed them up with your defense, not with your offense.
And they steal by McNamara. Great read.
After a three by McCroskey, McNamara's shot rattled out. Here's Krauser leading a two-on-one. McNamara trying to hustle back. Taft, the dunk.
Well, Robert should have just stayed there, faked and recovered. A great play by Krauser. And Taft getting the puppies up and down. And, Jay, I think they can get offensive rebounds on Krauser's side now.
Well, I'll tell you, he really bogarted. It looked like it was Warwick inside just knocking him aside to get that rebound.
Warwick fouled on his way to the bucket.
Pittsburgh with the quick run out. It was Krauser that grabbed it, took it all by himself, and the black magic from the Bronx.
How about that, huh? Put the double X over his head. All a little one fake and recover drill, though, by Roberts. They love the block shots and paid for it.
And it was all one-handed by Carl Krauser. And when he plays instinctively, you're talking to Joe Lombardi, an assistant coach for Pittsburgh, and they felt like they might have overcoached him earlier in the season, trying to get a little more control out of Carl Krauser. But they need to let him be more instinctive, more like Brett Favre is in football. You have to live with a couple interceptions to get the good stuff, and there is a lot of good stuff with Krauser.
It's like trying to control Sean McDonough. I mean, you just got to let him go.
We're trying to let him go.
I was going
to
say,
won't leave.
When are you planning on letting him go? Neither one of you stops talking.
Well, look at
meanwhile,
this.
During the debate, there were two free throws made by Hakeem Warwick, and now a turnover by Pittsburgh.
Well, they are rattled right now. Very much so. Not the poise you see under Jamie Dixon's guys.
And going back to man-to-man now.
An 11-2 run, fueled by the pressure brought by Syracuse.
You know, pin-down series, and maybe a dump in.
And they're doing it with McNamara off to another slow start, shooting the ball, 1 for 5 from the floor. 3-second violation, the call against Terrence Roberts.
That looked like I thought he was signaling a foul. It was Roberts with the 3 seconds. Well, he signaled to the scorer's table about Robertson.
Krauser dribbles through the pressure. The lob intended for Mark McCarroll, broken up by Roberts.
What a heads-up play, and he sprints to the rim.
Warwick with Roberts, Nichols, McNamara, and McCroskey for Syracuse. Graves, Krauser, McCarroll just off the bench. Kendall and Taft, with Troutman getting a rest for Pittsburgh.
Interesting how they handle this one. A nice cover by Taft in the back.
McNamara tried to jam it underneath, and Krauser deflected it out of bounds.
Heads up play here. Really paying attention to detail. Tough to lob it over Roberts. He can elevate with the best of them.
13 to shoot for the Orange. They were whacked in this building by Pittsburgh last year. Scored only 45 points in the game. Ward, the miss and the rebound to Kendall. Here's Krauser.
What a cross.
And he missed the layup. Warwick hits the deck. Crowd thought he was shoved down. The officials say last touch by Warwick.
Well, a guy by the name of the Pearl used to do a number in this building with a crossover. This is gorgeous basketball, everything but as he gets into the lane.
Graves for Taft, who's called for a walk. Where Taft's had an up and down season. Talking to pit coaches, you get the feeling that maybe other people around the country expected too much from him. A lot of hype at the start of the year, including a big write-up in ESPN the magazine, we might add. And maybe that came a little too early.
I think it did. I think he's athletic, and he's having a normal progression for a really good college player, but his skill level needs a lot of work.
I thought Jamie's point about he's big, and there are not a whole lot of big guys in the country. Everybody got attracted to his performance, and he can light it up once in a while, as Akeem can. But I think it's just about work and sticking to it. A long way to go.
Graves fouled on a reach-in. Of course, a couple of big Mondays ago, we saw Taft have a 25-point game against Providence. But Saturday, just 1 point against Notre Dame. He had 6 rebounds, played 17 minutes, did not play in the final 11:40 with a back-and-forth finish.
Well, he's very raw offensively, and he's got power post moves, but he doesn't really have any counter moves. So if you take away his power move, he doesn't have anything to go to yet.
He loves that. I'm sorry.
Three that missed by Graves. Roberts lost control, and it was deflected out by Pittsburgh.
I think the predictability is one of his problems. He likes to go to that left shoulder with that turnaround hook. I think that's what scouting does. You've got to come, as you mentioned, with counters. Develop a little flexibility in your game.
Guys are always going to take away what you want to do first.
Roberts, the turnaround, deflected by Troutman. McCroskey ripped it away from Graves, and then McCroskey was fouled.
I think Troutman, Sean.
It is on Troutman, his first. Just the third team foul. It's been a relatively foul-free first 11 and a half minutes, 3 fouls on each team.
That's not a Troutman kind of foul either. He likes to get his pound of flesh.
McNamara had it carom back to Nichols. And Graves the rebound.
Nice look by Kendall.
Taft was left alone underneath the bucket. Kendall found him, and Pittsburgh is within one.
The bigs ran the floor. Syracuse not hustling back.
McNamara with 5 assists tonight, only 2 points, but the 5 assists give him 402 for his career. He's moved into the top 10 in Syracuse history in assists as a junior. He passed Greg Monroe. And immediate timeout. Syracuse will have 18 to shoot when we come back with more Big Monday presented by Bud Light.
I think this could be a problem.
I think this could be a big problem.
I think we should drive that bad boy.
For research.
Oh, yeah, research.
Lease a 2005 Mazda 6i Sport Sedan for $199 per month for 42 months with $19.99 due at lease signing. Do a little research of your own. Get to your Mazda dealer for a test drive now.
ESPN searches for the next NBA analyst. Former NBA players Barrows, Wilkins, Reed, Bullard, Brown, and Dawkins take their shot at the analyst job. The new season of Dream Job, live Sunday, February 27th at 10 on ESPN.
Everyone wants it. Basketball's got it. ESPN College Game Day, Saturdays at 11.
Fueled by Mountain Dew.
$600 million of your tax dollars is a lot of money. $600 million tax dollars could be used to hire 7,000 additional teachers, or buy a 500,000 new computers, or provide new school books for every student at every school in New York State. But some want to spend even more than $600 million tax dollars on a football stadium. That's the wrong priority. Our children should come before a football stadium. Say no to a West Side Stadium.
How you doing? This is Carl Krauser. I wanted to wish my family back in New York and everybody in Pittsburgh happy Valentine's Day.
I'm Jerry McNamara from Syracuse University. I'd like to wish a happy Valentine's Day to Scranton, Pennsylvania.
He loves Scranton, his hometown, and they love him. Frequently, busloads of folks from Scranton make the bus ride up here to Central New York to watch Jerry and the Orange in action. It's Big Monday, presented by Bud Light. And then fixtures here at the Dome, Jerry's parents, Jerry and Joyce McNamara.
I was always happy when we played on Valentine's Day, so I would have an excuse not to have a date.
You don't need an excuse. McNamara with Pace, Warwick, Forth, and McCroskey for Syracuse. Troutman's back in for Pittsburgh. Seven to shoot.
Gotta give him a screen.
Well, he's in trouble. Had to throw up a desperation heave that got no rim.
They started the clock over. Shouldn't have been. Should have been a violation. They got
violation. Curtis Shaw alert to that. They reset the shot clock, but they shouldn't have because the ball never hit the rim.
Explaining it to Jimmy right now.
So a chance for the lead for Pittsburgh as we tick down to 7.5 minutes left in the first half.
Sean, these low numbers are dangerous for Syracuse, I think. Now they got to rev it up, get something off their D here. And Pitt, as noted earlier, they don't mind pounding it.
Last couple of years in the top five in the nation in scoring defense, giving up just 61 points per game this year. That's up from 56 last year. The good news for Pittsburgh, they're scoring more this year at 74 points per game.
And they need to attack the right side because the left side has Josh Pace on the backside. They can get some offensive boards.
Troutman all alone with Craig Forth on the floor for Syracuse, and Pittsburgh reclaims the lead by one.
Did you notice the post pass by Kendall, the left hand? He does some nice things.
He's got some really good skills. And he's got a good feel.
Mm-hmm.
For a lot of things, plays the drums, the piano, the mountain bike racer, cliff diver, likes whitewater rafting, meditation, snowboarding, is into Buddhism, his father a musician.
How does he have
time
to play?
Levon says, I'm kind of a laid-back West Coast guy myself.
I guess you didn't have time to work out today. All that info.
He's an interesting young man. Was heading for a mid-major school on the West Coast in all likelihood before Jamie Dixon spotted him at a sneaker camp in the summer up in Canada when he went to take a look at Denham Brown, who wound up going to Connecticut.
It's amazing how many often that happens. Nice penetration here.
McCroskey, he's been a force off the bench. He's another one of those sophomores Jim Boeheim's always talking about who he'd like to see more from. Ramon thought about a long three. Ramon with Kendall, Troutman, Taft, Krauser for Pittsburgh. 6 minutes to go in the half.
They are staying left. They got a 3-second violation on Taft. He thought Troutman was going to shoot it.
Tomorrow night at 7 Eastern, more Big East basketball on Super Tuesday presented by Toyota. Connecticut against Providence. The Friars off their win yesterday over Rutgers. And Kentucky at South Carolina at 9 Eastern time. Super Tuesday presented by Toyota on ESPN and ESPN2.
Connecticut put on an impressive rebounding and shot blocking display against North Carolina.
First three of the night for McNamara. He's 1 for 3 from beyond the arc.
And to the delight of his parents, the Orange back up by four.
Well, it was interesting. They were trying to establish Warwick in the lane. And here comes a little small change. Maybe a play on.
Wait. McNamara is getting screened up the top of that zone on almost every possession.
There's that locked low, Jay.
Yeah, it's just a little 1-4 right. Set, the UCLA cut, and then a down screen.
He keeps active, too, though, without the basketball.
Two fouls on Warwick now. Four on the Orange, four against Pittsburgh as well. Troutman trying to dribble away from a double team. Krauser left alone, and Long with a three. Kendall crashes the boards.
Once again, contributing.
Ramon for three.
Well, he has got a beautiful stroke. Fluid, steps right into that jump shot, but all because of LeVon Kendall.
Pittsburgh hanging in there because of the rebounding edge. 19-6 is the margin right now on the boards.
And I think that's the best time to shoot a three is after an offensive rebound.
Fourth missed the tip after the McCroskey miss. Another chance for the lead for Pittsburgh. Gray took a little long to shoot it. Warwick deflected it, but went right to Kendall, who scored to put the Panthers up.
And once again, the bigs aren't getting down the floor.
Well, Craig Forth had fallen down after that attempted tip.
But Warwick didn't get back. McCroskey didn't get back.
Terrence Roberts is going to come back in for Syracuse. Josh Pace in the lane. McCroskey a tip out to Gray. This is four
numbers.
On two. Ramon wide open for three. And a foul on the rebounding action.
Number
if that's
three.
On Warwick, and it is, it's his third.
Wow.
Well, we saw foul trouble really plague Syracuse in the loss last Monday night here to Connecticut. And that's a major blow. Warwick takes a seat with three. Roberts into the ball game. I think they were trying to get him in for fourth. His fourth has also gone out. Demetrius Nichols back in.
Well, it is so hard playing against a team that is as physical as Pittsburgh because you tend to clutch and grab against a physical team like the Panthers.
Carroll had an easy one. Roberts got a little piece of him. But Troutman causes a lot of problems. He initiates contact, frustrates people. They got the walk here.
Traveling the call against Demetrius Nichols, a sophomore from Boston. Jim Boeheim hoping that he'll find his confidence, former Rhode Island High School Player of the Year. From Boston, he went to high school at St. Andrew in Rhode Island.
Always a threat.
John DeGroat in the ballgame now, number zero for Pittsburgh. Krauser steps into a three. Roberts the rebound. Syracuse looks to run.
Ooh, that was dangerous.
McNamara bumped by Ramon. Second foul on Ramon. And as usual, he's provided offense off the bench. Pittsburgh by one.
On the next tilt, the big game is on.
This town doesn't think too highly of cheaters.
And what happens next will shock you. Tilt, Thursday at 9 p.m. on ESPN, presented by Toyota.
The Wendy's Wildcard Dream Job Sweepstakes. More Biggie Cups means more chances to win. Just find the code on your cup, then log on to ESPN.com/dreamjob. You could win a trip to the ESPN headquarters in Bristol.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the SUV Championships.
Anybody riding an SUV? Not everybody rides it right.
He's pushing it too hard.
Without respect for what they're capable of, it's easy to see why a lot of riders take the role. SUVs are big and powerful, and on top of one, you can feel almost invincible.
Easy now, big fella.
Keeping your SUV in off course.
Look at that control.
That's the idea, right?
Morning.
Are you ready for school?
Why wouldn't I be?
One of the toughest parts of being a parent is trying to understand what your kids are going through.
No matter what I do, I'm not good enough. I want to talk to my friends, but they just think I'm in a bad mood.
If your teen is struggling with depression, the Girls in Boys Town National Hotline can help you help your kids. Call 1-800-448-3000 for a free booklet.
Sorry, I'm late, guys. Just trying to decipher these numbers. It's fine.
Visit the largest job website, careerbuilder.com. A better job awaits.
Hi, Chris Fowler with Digger Phelps and Mike Jarvis on the UPS Halftime Report, the latest on the labor mess in the NHL. Some Valentine's presents to some bubble teams from these guys.
Not for me. Hey, Pitt just killing them on the boards, Mike. 27 with 4 to go. I don't understand that because Syracuse is a little bit better than that on the board.
Well, I'll tell you what I don't understand is I don't understand why teams, and particularly Syracuse, is impressing Pitt a lot more than they are. Go after them.
We'll see you at halftime. Warm Valentine's wishes from the studio to the dome.
Yes.
And apparently that Valentine spirit has not pervaded the Carrier Dome. The sign says, our wife said, us or college basketball, we're going to miss them. Now, you think it's those guys over there? Because the sign is actually below a few women there.
I think it's the guys on the
those
right.
Those are the culprits on the right?
Maybe it's not their wives.
They'll be getting TV dinners from here on out, I would assume. Now, you were here when it was Manly, right?
Yes.
And that atmosphere was incredible. I never thought they would be able to do it in this building, but they've been able to do it.
Yep, some said it's crazy to move into this big building. Why would you move out of 9,000-seat Manly Fieldhouse? All they've done here is set all the on-campus attendance records, including 33,199 for Notre Dame a week and a half ago to break their own on-campus college basketball single-game record. Held ball, and it'll go over to Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh has more offensive rebounds than Syracuse has total rebounds. That should tell you the domination that the Panthers.
The only thing that's keeping the score close is the turnovers. Pittsburgh's had 11 turnovers to just 6 for the Orange.
And the runouts have hurt Syracuse as well. Not a big team out there right now.
Warwick on the bench with 3 fouls. A carry called against Krauser. 4 ties, 4 lead changes in the ball game. With 3 minutes to go, a chance for Syracuse to change the lead again as Darryl Watkins comes in.
Allen Iverson lives. I think it all started with him in this league. They started to pick on him, and there's Carl Krauser in the playground. Gets away with that. No, you don't dare call that.
Watkins in with Nichols, Roberts, McCroskey, and McNamara. Watkins had it for a second. Troutman knocked it away. Then McNamara's Roberts all alone underneath. Kendall rallied back in time to foul.
Sticking with it. Talk about feisty. You mentioned the Scranton flash. He arouses people in this building. This is the finish, but it's all hustle. And I think that's what you have to do when you play Pitt. You got to be scrappy and get down and dirty.
And McNamara just will not quit on the ball. He pursues it until he gets it.
Roberts missed the free throw. Troutman had the rebound with Nichols on his back. Syracuse by 1, 2.5 to go until halftime.
Where they make the center move. You see Troutman and Taft keep Watkins busy.
And they stay behind the zone. Tough to find.
Look at this. Disperse the ball out of that middle. Tough on the D.
Krauser. Just 1 out of 8 from the floor. Troutman fouled by Watkins.
Well, he had help from the rear and Roberts, too, but so effective what they've been able to run against the defense here, Jake. Passing.
And Pittsburgh just being more physical. Not only Troutman, but also when Kendall was making his cut through the lane, he just slammed right into Roberts, knocking him off his path.
Did you see a foul?
No, I
think
it was
Roberts was clean. Watkins was underneath.
Watkins was backing up. Well, Troutman missed the first free throw. I think that was one of those anticipation whistles.
Do you notice with Syracuse, people are really making an attempt to get inside far more than they did in other years? Mm-hmm. Not settling for the deep shot.
Troutman missed both. McCroskey the rebound in traffic. So Syracuse with a 1-point lead. They haven't lost ground with Warwick on the bench for a couple of minutes now.
with the three fouls.
Boy, Troutman pushes the envelope, though. He's on the brink of getting the foul, then backs off.
McCroskey, or rather Nichols, missed the three. He just can't get that confidence back with the shooting stroke. 0 for 3 off the bench tonight, including 0 for 2 from three-point land.
How about getting to the rim then? And that's what he should do, be a little more selective. Get on the board, get the confidence.
He's not as good with the dribble, Nichols, as he is as a standstill shooter.
Nice look here.
Roberts the dunk from McNamara.
Draw the D and send it in out of Jersey City.
Krauser in transition, a quick three. Battle for the rebound, controlled by Roberts. Nichols started a drive. McNamara. And a foul against Pittsburgh on the rebounding action. McCroskey had the rebound, and he got bumped on the floor.
Boy, long jump shots. Pitt's got a nice flow. They take the long jump shot, and right here, the ability to find somebody with the dribble.
Troutman helps up, and that's what left Roberts open along the baseline. A good catch because he had his hands ready.
Foul on Krauser is second. It puts Pittsburgh over the limit. A 1-1 for McCroskey. He's a poor free throw shooter, 48% for the year. Krauser, Kendall, Graves, Troutman. Taft is the other player on the floor for Pittsburgh. Nichols called for a foul. That'll put Syracuse over the limit. It's the first on Demetrius Nichols.
But Troutman just lands him in the lane. I mean, that's unbelievable how he shapes up.
And Jim Boeheim really sort of getting a break here, having Hakeem Warrick on the bench for this long and still able to keep the lead.
So Troutman back at the line. He's already attempted 6 free throws. That's the 7th. He's 4 of 7 from the line. Warrick has been on the bench for about 3 minutes now. Although it's hard to say that's the bench. He's actually seated along the baseline up against the signage. I've kind of gone with the Laker feel here at the Carrier Dome with those new seats along the baseline for some of their fans.
Well, Gucci Row, they used to say in Vegas.
What's going to be here? Chicken wing row?
They love their hoops in this town, though.
They sure do. Remarkable. I think Jim Boeheim told us something like 275,000 people within a 70-mile radius of Syracuse. You think that about 10% of them are in here night in and night out to watch the Orange play. Krauser, he's had a rough half. Lost it off his leg. Roberts stripped by Graves.
And McNamara was trying to get him to give the ball up. That's why big guys should find out the guards.
Troutman collided with Roberts. And then a foul called by John Clogarty. Josh Pace called for the foul, and he was hopping mad about it.
So this is how he plays now. He just bangs his guy. He had shaped up earlier and begged it. He loves the contact. Here a little pratfall, but he's going back for more.
Now, we all admire Troutman, and the way he plays, the way he conducts himself. A fascinating life story from Williamsport, Pennsylvania. At one time or another during his childhood, both parents were imprisoned. His mother for 13 years. Most of his childhood. He's one of 8 children, and he wears a couple of tattoos. Only the strong survive, and only God knows the plan. It is his faith that has helped him through those difficult circumstances. When he first got to school, thought about going home, his dad said, there's nothing back here that's good for you to get involved in. Stay in school. He frequently didn't have enough money to call home. And what a young man he is. He has graduated already with a degree in communications.
Have you seen a happier guy in practice? His personality has blossomed at Pitt.
When we talked to Joe Lombardi, the assistant today, he said every day he comes into practice with a smile on his face, always happy.
Huh.
With what he's overcome, that says a lot about him. Big Monday continues, presented by Bud Light. Kansas ranked number 2, taking on Bob Knight's 25th ranked Texas Tech. And then at midnight Eastern time, Air Force and New Mexico. Big Monday presented by Bud Light. We have a big audience here in Syracuse for that midnight game. They have Mountain West Monday. A lot of the students who are in the communication school here get together to watch the game.
Well, I'm not sure you just circle Texas Tech there. I'm not sure there's anybody in the Big 12, maybe even the country, that's running better motion offense than Texas Tech is.
Well, they've always been quite good at it under Bob Knight, no matter where he's been. And Jackson playing well on and off. Ross had a big game last week, Connell Ross.
Martin Zeno. And they're driving the ball more. They're an athletic team, and they are going to be in the NCAA tournament.
Edelin back in. Syracuse can take the last shot. McCroskey, medium-range jumper. Pace couldn't time the jump right. McNamara. It took an extra bounce on the rim. Graves a heave. And
McNamara's
we're at halftime.
McNamara's down.
Back and forth, half, five ties, six lead changes, and Jerry McNamara is still down on the court, grabbing his left shin.
He is hurting.
The rest of the team's gone off the court. Josh Pace there to look after him, and now the medical staff is on the scene. But obviously, if he could not continue, that would be a critical loss for Syracuse, which survived the foul trouble of Warwick to remain within one here at halftime. Let's go back and see if we can ascertain when McNamara hurt himself.
What a fluky fall, huh?
McNamara on the drive, bumping into Antonio Graves.
Right there underneath. What a shame.
Boy, he still cannot get up. As we look at the replays, he is still on the floor and grimacing in pain. We'll keep an eye on this as we send you back for halftime. At the half, Pittsburgh leads Syracuse 29-28. Let's send you back now to the studio. Here's Chris Fowler.
Mike Jarvis alongside. This is the UPS halftime report. And of course, we'll monitor McNamara's situation as the Orange are down by one. We'll talk hoops with these guys very soon. But first, guys, no warm Valentine's news. Still no love to the NHL owners and players. And hope rapidly melting away by the moment of salvaging something of this season. Already two-thirds of it are gone. And now sources are saying the Commissioner Gary Bettman will call a 1 o'clock Eastern time press conference on Wednesday to call off the remainder of the season. Last-ditch efforts undergoing today between owners and players. But so far, no positive news. It would be the first time a major sports season has been canceled by a labor problem. Well, who's going to get locked out of the NCAA tournament? We'll talk about that coming up. Bubble teams, Notre Dame, can they survive the tough Big East schedule down the stretch? And what about Texas, shorthanded and losing games in bunches right now?
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by SUV.com and DirecTV. DirecTV is rethinking the way television should be.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the SUV Championships.
Anybody can ride an SUV. Not everybody rides it right.
He's pushing it too hard.
Without respect for what they're capable of, it's easy to see why a lot of riders take the roll. SUVs are big and powerful. And on top of one, you can feel almost invincible.
Easy now, big fella.
Keeping your SUV in off course.
Look at that control.
That's the idea, right? Ooh.
Television. It started out simply enough.
I can explain nothing.
And as it evolves, we follow its every move, loyal to the end. With top-ranking customer satisfaction and a commitment to providing the very best TV experience, it's time. It's time to rethink TV.
Hey, Angie, you going to the post office? Hey, Ted, you going to the post office?
Do I know you?
Anyone go to the post office? Jeff.
Ronnie.
Connie. Isn't anyone going to the post office?
Hey, Chuck. Can't go to the post office? Go to USPS.com.
From buying stamps to shipping packages, almost anything you do at the post office, you can do at USPS.com. It's how the U.S. Postal Service is working for you.
Hey, Steve. Lunch?
There she is over there. 72, 73, something like that. They should get some of that dust off there. Susan used to drive that car. I think she was going to come back for it. Holy.
No luxury brand holds its value better than BMW, the ultimate driving machine.
Lease a 2005 BMW 325i for $309 a month until February 28th.
You think about the conditions people have to drive in, how they're not always perfect. Then you build the 2005 Volvos with electronically controlled all-wheel drive. For confidence on any road.
Welcome back to the UPS Halftime Report.
All right, Pittsburgh up one. The story, of course, Jerry McNamara and the health of that ankle. We'll check on that as he was injured just before halftime at Syracuse. New coaches poll is out. We'll count it down from 25. Two new teams popping in, Charlotte and Florida.
Florida's on a run with David Lee, Anthony Roberson, as well as Matt Welch playing tough the way they should with their experience.
Mike, Connecticut, an opportunity missed is how Calhoun called it, losing to Carolina.
Well, no doubt about it, but a week ago I wondered why they moved up to 14. They beat Syracuse. They lose to Carolina by 7 at home without Rashad Anderson. I thought they should have at least stayed where they were.
Pittsburgh at 15, ranked behind Washington and Utah. Of course, the Huskies went down.
Arizona, big win at UCLA. Stoudemire as well as Channing Frye making things happen for Lil Olsen's team as they climb near the top 10.
You've had your eye, Mike, on Boston College all season long.
Well, I have, and I'm going to continue to stay with the Eagles. And they're 20-1. There's nothing to be ashamed of. Tough loss at Notre Dame, as Digger predicted. And that probably hurt more than the fact that they lost.
Well, because I predicted it.
Movement in the top five. Carolina loses at Duke, beats UConn, and drops.
I was at that Carolina game yesterday with UConn. UConn had 16 blocks. That means Carolina is soft in a lot of those situations. Take the ball through the rim, Tar Heels. Through the rim, through the player. Get the foul.
And, of course, the mighty Illini consensus number one. The quest continues. Let's talk bubble now. At the big board now, talking bubble. We got 10 teams up here, two columns, in or out as of tonight. Some of these teams are charitably labeled bubble teams, by the way. We'll get to that. Notre Dame, 5-5 the last 10, Digger.
Well, it's Valentine's Day. My heart goes with the Irish because when you look at the Irish, their schedule is the toughest in the Big East Conference play. They have two games against Connecticut, Syracuse, Pittsburgh, Villanova, Georgetown. One game which they knocked off with Boston College. Those six schools combined are 104-26. The toughest schedule gets them a bid, even if they're 8-8.
All right, next up, Villanova, also a tough schedule in the Big East.
Tough schedule, 5-5 right now, but that win over Kansas is huge. If they get to 500, which I believe they can, I believe they'll be in.
Miami, a surprise story in the ACC. A couple of quality wins against teams like Florida and Florida State.
Great, great backcourt play. They've got a huge game coming up against Virginia Tech. I believe if they win that game, I would say they're going to be on that left side in the end.
They got some tough games down the stretch in the ACC. Hokies do get to host the Hurricanes in the game.
Tough loss at Virginia over the weekend. They're out. They're starting to fade. I just don't think they're going to be strong enough to finish in the ACC tournament.
NC State sliding. Stopped the bleeding a little bit by beating Georgia Tech, but still 4-7
in the league. 4-7 with home games, though. Tonight, they're out. But with the home games against North Carolina, Maryland this week, as well as Wake Forest, they have a chance to still slide in.
NC State on the loser's side. Texas, without P.J. Tucker, just 2-4. Nothing is automatic for the Longhorns these days.
They could be fading away, and that's really dangerous because they got some road games like Oklahoma State at the end where that could really knock them out.
Big Ten, Indiana, 11-10. They have the one win against the RPI top 50, but a winning record in the league.
I think that gets them in. They're 6-4. They win a couple more ball games.
In the middle?
No, I think they're in.
You guys both think they're in.
They're the fourth best team right now in the conference because Minnesota's starting to fade, and that's the next team we want to talk about because of that loss to Northwestern at home. They finished the season on the road. Gene Katie's farewell game, and then senior night at Penn State. They could fade out. I really mean
Hoosiers in Gophers. That would be controversial in Minnesota.
Well, they beat them.
Yes,
already,
it would.
So
be.
Stanford,
that's
no
right.
Grunfeld. Also a team missing a key player. Where do you see the Cardinals?
Well, it depends. I really think it's going to come down to the UCLA game. If they win that, they're in. They lose it, they're out. I'd put them in the middle.
In the middle. All right. Comes down to the middle. LSU, competitive SEC West. Battling for spots.
Third place.
Over there.
Well, they're actually tied right now with Mississippi State. Of course, when you look at Florida and Kentucky and Alabama, top three, I think they're going to get five in, and they're right there right now. Tonight, they're in. Right. If they have a collapse, then they'll be out. But there's how it looks as it stands right now, Mike.
Yes, I believe they'll get five in.
Semi-consensus, five in, four out, and Stanford sitting there on the bubble. Opinions can change as Selection Sunday approaches. In the first half, Carl Krauser just 1 of 9 for the four, but that's the same shooting that McNamara has had. Pittsburgh up by one at the Dome. Second half coming up soon.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
It's my job at UPS to make sure our planes can get around bad weather. Hey, the weather can be unpredictable. The time your package arrives, shouldn't be.
UPS delivers more packages on time than anyone. UPS. What can Brown do for you?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the SUV Championships.
Anybody can ride an SUV. Not everybody rides it right.
He's pushing it too hard.
Without respect for what they're capable of, it's easy to see why a lot of riders take the role. SUVs are big and powerful. And on top of one, you can feel almost invincible.
Easy now, big fella.
Keeping your SUV in off course.
Look at that control.
That's the idea, right?
Ooh.
Tuesday, most ignored day of the week. Hey, kids, you want to play?
No, thanks.
Friday's here!
Friday.
But now, that's all going to change. Domino's is making me the most fun day of the week.
Now, Tuesday is special. Domino's is offering two pizzas for the price of one.
I feel like a brand new day!
Get the door. It's Domino's 2x Tuesday. It's 2x Tuesday at Domino's. Buy any large pizza at regular menu price and get a second pizza of equal or lesser value free on Tuesdays. That's two pizzas for the price of one Tuesdays only at Domino's.
Excuse me, you're still with your old brokerage firm?
I know, but I like being able to talk to somebody when I have a question.
Look, I don't want to be out there in cyberspace all by myself.
We moved our money to a TD Waterhouse online account. Their people really make us feel connected.
TD Waterhouse has investment consultants you can talk to when you have a question, so you're not out there all on your own. You can do this. Switch to TD Waterhouse, the alternative to higher-priced brokers like Merrill Lynch and Smith Barney.
This is the UPS Halftime Report.
Go to ESPN.com. Vote on this week's big man on campus, Warwick of the Orange, Gilchrist, hero of Maryland's big win. Darius Jackson, you'll see him coming up against Kansas, guys. This is a Kansas team that comes in rolling on the road, but Texas Tech has been certainly tough at home, Mike.
Well, they have, 13-1, and I think also the motion offense is in the heads and minds of the Kansas players and staff.
I'm interested defensively how Bob Knight and Texas Tech stopped Wayne Simmons. He had 25-12 against Colorado. He's the best guy with double-doubles in that conference.
And midnight following SportsCenter, the Falcons and Los Lobos from Albuquerque. Second half is coming up. Chevy Troutman, just one field goal for the Panthers. This was it here, but he was a force on the boards. Road team up by a point. Begin the second half right after this.
This halftime report is delivered by UPS. What can Brown do for you?
That restaurant was great.
Yeah, it's one of my favorites.
Is that where you take all your first dates?
Maybe.
Oh! That girl almost hit me.
Women drivers.
Introducing the highly maneuverable Mercury Mariner.
It's love.
Onto the field.
Electrify the last row. Take the ultimate ride. Shatter records. Start a movement. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
Have you ever dreamt that buying a car could be as easy as shopping at the supermarket? Well, your dreams have come true at ableford.com. In a no-pressure, customer-friendly environment, you can research, find, and service your vehicle 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Things have never been easier, and prices have never been lower. So go online and receive the best purchase experience of your life at ableford.com.
Make a smooth approach. Make smooth contact with Electric Shave Pre-Shave Lotion. Stands up whiskers for up to a 52% closer shave. Electric Shave. Blade close. Electric smooth.
When I had a cold sore, I wouldn't leave my cube. But then my pharmacist recommended Herpesin L. It helps heal cold sores fast. Moisturizers help prevent cracking. And it even has SPF 30. Herpesin L. Every day.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Mercury and your local Lincoln Mercury dealers and Nike Pro Apparel.
Closely contested first half throughout. The largest lead was 6 for Pittsburgh. They lead by 1 at the break. Syracuse taking advantage of the turnovers from Pittsburgh as the Panthers turned it over 13 times, but the rebounding edge dramatically in favor of Pittsburgh. The stats brought to you by Mazda. Louis McCroskey just 2 points shy of his career high with those 9 for Syracuse to lead the Orange in the first half. But the big moment of the half perhaps was at the very end of the half when Jerry McNamara was involved in this collision.
Yeah, McNamara just rolled that left ankle as he was going into the lane. He said he didn't really know what happened. He was in the trainer's room. They were taping it up. And he walked back on the court and will be prepared to play.
Got a hand as he came out after his teammates. Got a big hand from the relieved crowd. Just happy to see him walk back onto the court. So he's going to try to give it a go. What do you guys look for in the second half?
Boy, Syracuse got to do a better job rebounding. They weren't as physical as they needed to be in that first half. And Robertson McCroskey combined for 7 of 10 from the field. The rest of the team, 5 of 22.
I think they're going to be in trouble if Pitt values the basketball and takes better shots, quite frankly. I thought the guards didn't do as good a job late in the first half for Pitt. But I don't think he's walking well, by the way, just judging. But you know what that'll mean? He'll light it up 10 for 10 or something. Such a tough, tough competitor.
Well, an injury to McNamara. Foul trouble for Warwick. They're the two best players for Syracuse. Both in there to start the second half with Pace, Forth, and Edel in the same five that started the game. Krauser, Graves, Kendall, Troutman, Taft for Pittsburgh. Warwick, Forth.
He's got Kendall on him. He wanted to take advantage, McNamara.
Pace is patting and a runner wouldn't go, and it's ripped down by Krauser, who's an excellent rebounding guard. He averages just under 5 per game.
Krauser was 1 for 9 in that first half, also coughed it up 3 times.
Didn't you think he took a lot of quick shots, Jay?
Yeah, trying to take advantage of getting down quickly. I did think he took some too many shots without a pass.
There's a 3 for Antonio Graves, his 2nd 3 of the ball game to give him 6 points. You mentioned Krauser, he was 1 for 9, and McNamara was 2 for 9, so the 2-star guards in this game both well off their usual play. McNamara did have 7 assists. They'll kick ball and they reset the shot clock.
Sean, he's moving pretty well without the basketball. He ran, used screens, screened himself, popped out.
Forth, short with the shot.
Trying to take advantage of Troutman size-wise. He bellied up. And look at him underneath here, loading up.
Forth is scoreless in the game. He had 8 points and 10 rebounds against Villanova Saturday after being scoreless in the 2 games prior to that. He saves the ball along the end line. Here's McNamara running very well and out of control. He charges. after trying to throw a wild behind the back pass. Wasn't trying to throw a wild pass, but threw a wild pass without trying to.
I thought he had pace, and then he got stuck, no question about it. But the good thing, at least, not necessarily the foul, but his mobility.
Second foul on McNamara. And here are the fans clapping in the background. That's a Syracuse tradition. They stay on their feet and clap until the first point of the half by Syracuse. It hasn't happened yet. They're down by four. Kendall bidding to make it seven. Taft, the offensive rebound.
Good ball movement by Krauser.
And a nice pass by Graves to Troutman to send him back to the line.
Well, that was a good set. Very unselfish, almost Pitt-style basketball, eventually getting it inside. Good job by Troutman getting himself in position to do some damage.
Boy, and they attacked off the dribble off of ball reversal. That was really impressive. That's what made the play.
It's already the 11th free throw for Troutman. He's 7 for 11. Fourth and Edelin go out. Roberts and McCroskey in. Troutman is the only Pitt player to shoot a free throw tonight, but he has shot more than the Syracuse team combined. He's attempted 11. Syracuse is 2 out of 4 from the line.
Well, he's dished out a couple of assists and about 12 bruises.
Yeah, Corliss Williamson comes to mind, the old Arkansas player, and of course now with the Sixers, physically as imposing.
Troutman once had 37 rebounds in a high school game. That was against Bishop Hannon, which is Jerry McNamara's alma mater. McNamara off the mark and Taft the rebound.
Oh, what a steal.
McNamara anticipated the pass and then Krauser fouled him.
What anticipation. That took some quickness.
And that's three personals on Carl Krauser.
Not only the anticipation, but the execution, waiting till he put it down and going right after the ball. That is big time there.
And Krauser gave him the wrap with the left arm. Krauser had a couple of teeth loosened in their win over Notre Dame Saturday. Spent about 5 minutes on the bench with the dentist as play continued. Warwick is fouled by Taft.
I think this Pittsburgh team keeps a lot of dental professionals employed.
I was thinking Troutman unloads on a few in the course of an evening. Nice drop step, his favorite move.
Roberts there to follow up the miss by Warwick.
The dribble got the attention. And Roberts, who gets up quickly, attacks the tin.
Well, Jim Boeheim's away for some of the sophomores to step up and help McNamara and Warwick. And tonight it's McCroskey and Roberts, who have been very strong off the bench.
We've got to watch Ramon on the other wing.
Kendall wide open after, again, great ball movement by Pittsburgh. Here's McCroskey, a three to tie it for Syracuse. McNamara bidding for the tie.
So he sets his man up beautifully. There really wasn't a screen, Jay. He just times it and they snap it back.
Timeout, Pittsburgh. Jamie Dixon with the shot clock at 17, and the crowd engaged after the three by McNamara. That tied it up. Second three ball of the night for McNamara. He has 8 points.
Introducing Mercury Mariner with the gentle assist of a rear sensing system.
She's good.
Honey,
to kill you to change the role.
Oh. Hey, look, I just booked our Vegas trip on Expedia.
Create your next trip on Expedia with extra savings when you book your flight and hotel together and the most travel options anywhere.
Expedia.com.
The bigger the stage, the bigger the opportunity. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
There are riding mowers, and then there's the Edge cutting system. Only John Deere gives you the Edge. With dependability beneath you and your John Deere dealer behind you, you'll always have a John Deere yard to look forward to. Own a John Deere now starting at $14.99. Nothing runs like a deer.
Sean McDonough setting it up live. It looked like he was doing this all on his own. And Jay, he just understands how to use his people.
Well, he just uses this little screen in transition by Terrence Roberts. Ramon had to go around it, couldn't get there. He does such a good job of setting his feet. When he goes straight up and down, he absolutely drills it. And I think this young man is going to play in the NBA. And he reminds me a little bit of Mark Price with the way that he plays.
The quick release, the toughness.
And quicker than he gets credit for.
And playing hurt, yeah. He looks slow with the uniform, but the puppies move.
There are a number of NBA scouts and a GM or two here tonight. There's a deep three by Kendall with a shot clock running out. No iron drawn, so it's a violation.
How often do you see that after timeout? Guys aren't ready, don't recognize the situation.
Well, that's the point guard's fault usually.
Orlando Antigua alongside Jamie, former Pitt great.
Rebounding Edge for Pittsburgh, but they've turned it over. Those two stats seem to be offsetting each other right now, and that's why we have a tie game. Taft just called for his third foul, and he's had another quiet night with just 6 points.
Taft trying to push him with his lower body off the block, and it's really amazing the pattern that Hakeem Warrick has shown over the last several games. He tends to fade away in the first half. In the second half, he goes more toward the basket, much more effective in second halves when he really goes toward the hole.
Yeah, wasted the dribble there. I'd like to see him turn and face more when he's 6-7 feet away.
McCroskey, and that's a career high for McCroskey. He's been huge off the bench for the Orange, 12 points, surpassing the 11 he had against Binghamton and St. John's earlier this year. Troutman fouled by Roberts.
And Roberts couldn't move. Aaron Gray locked him down.
And when we come back, Troutman will go back to a familiar spot, the free throw line.
Introducing Mercury Mariner. Save yourself the hassle. Get to.
Chicken Select from McDonald's. They're good.
Why? Because they say they're good? I bet they also say crispy.
Crispy is just a smoke screen.
Just like juicy chicken breast.
It is a juicy chicken breast strip.
They're controlling you, man.
Why don't you go to McDonald's and try one for free?
Now they have you believing it's free.
What? Look.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm not going to fall for that. Nice try.
Nothing's free.
Step onto the field. Electrify the last row. Take the ultimate ride. Shatter records. Start a movement. Greatness won't come to you. You have to reach for it. Bass, reach for greatness.
On March 4th,
I'm Lieutenant Shane Wolf.
America's top Navy SEAL is about to face his toughest assignment.
Protecting those kids is a matter of national security.
From Walt Disney Pictures.
Ma'am, I've dealt with...
Oh, my God!
That's scary.
He knows nothing about their world.
Babysitter.
But he's about to get...
We're gonna be late.
Not on my watch.
The ultimate crash course.
Land!
The Pacifier, rated PG.
We know Julie Boeheim would be happy about the Syracuse lead. I'm not sure she'd be happy about that sign.
Things are bad in that house.
Syracuse with a very strong RPI at 13. Generally, the speculation has been about seven Big East teams getting into the NCAA tournament. Interesting that Pittsburgh, with a record of 17-4, has an RPI of just 51.
Well, it's because of their non-conference schedule. They'll move up because of the tough games they've got coming up toward the end of the season in the Big East and also the Big East tournament.
When the committee sits down, the RPI, I mean, they don't even consider December. When
strength,
you think of
wait a minute. Howard, Robert Morris, Loyola of Maryland, St. Francis, Duquesne, Coppin State. Madison getting you big strength of schedule points.
Well, thank God for the conference, right?
They get on Boeheim for the schedule he plays. I mean, he plays a murderer's row compared to that group.
That's like an old memory, though.
Troutman at the line. He got some help during the trip to the line from Gray. The long arm extended to hold off Terrence Roberts, cleared the path for Troutman to the bucket.
Chevy making a living.
12 points, 10 of them from the free throw line for Troutman. The lead one for Syracuse. 4.5 gone by, second half, 24,631 in the Loud House tonight. That's small by Syracuse standards lately. McNamara, three.
He's got an uncanny ability of going left and righting himself just enough to knock the jumper down.
Pittsburgh handles the pressure. Gray blocked by Roberts. Krauser was stumbling, almost turned it over. Troutman got it back. Troutman is fouled.
What a competitor. Incredible pursuit of the basketball, but going left, which is something he likes to do, often with the dribble, but this time coming off the little dribble handoff, and that's a tough thing to defend. Here, just righting himself enough as he's sliding left, a little nylon at a sprint.
Sets himself and squares up, and even when he's tired, which he has to be after all the running he does in the Saturday-Monday turnaround, pretty impressive.
Maybe he should turn his other ankle. He's been much better in the second half.
As they say in showbiz, break an ankle, right? But the interesting thing I thought Jimmy said was that after the game on Saturday, he has trouble sleeping. I have the same problem myself.
You mean McNamara.
McNamara.
Not Boeheim.
But I have the same problem for different reasons. But it's a lot
of
energy.
You don't even try to go to sleep.
A lot of energy, and yet fresh tonight.
McNamara, 4 out of 12 shooting, 11 points, 6 of them in this half, 8 assists, bidding for another as he dumps down to Warwick, who was fouled before the dunk.
That's that left side of the floor. He either uses or refuses the screen or uses the dribble between the defender. Just really understands how to get his teammates involved.
Aaron Gray called for the foul, his first, the fourth against the Panthers, who trailed by two. Roberts fouled. Jamie Dixon wanted to travel. Instead, it's a foul called on Troutman, his second.
Syracuse just more resolute in this second half to get the ball inside and let Hakeem Warwick go to work.
There's Roberts. 0 for 1 from the line tonight. Now 1 for 2. For the sophomore from Jersey City out of St. Anthony.
And one of the nice things about having McNamara on your team, though, is Warwick can patiently bounce the ball in the box because they've got to hug the little guy deep.
Roberts has 9 points tonight. He had 3 points in just 5 minutes against Villanova. And after the game, speaking to the press, he questioned the substitution pattern of the future Hall of Famer Jim Boeheim. Some games we play a lot, other games not so much.
They ought to go left to Ramon.
Gray blocked again by Roberts. Well, that's one way to ensure that you'll see as much playing time as you'd like.
The young guys have played pretty well. Louis McCruskey knocking him down. But left, they've got Ramon. Here's a great effort at the end defensively. Terrific elevation anticipation. But I think they can drag Warwick away from the rim.
Shot clock running down. Graves, a runner, wouldn't go. Roberts just ripped it away from Taft.
Well, he's playing like a big timer right now.
Pace. Warwick battling Troutman. Troutman called for a bump with the leg, according to the gesture made by the official Curtis Shaw. Third foul on Troutman.
They actually could have called a few more of them, or at least a little bit early. Troutman trying to push Warwick off the box, and the book on Warwick, you try to be physical with him, but he is handling the physicality of this second half very effectively.
They're a little jumbled defensively here. They weren't sure what they were in.
Syracuse capitalizes. Pace to McCroskey, adding to his career high. 14 points on 6 out of 8. The fans chant Louis. Jamie Dixon calls a timeout.
You seldom see Pittsburgh unsure of what they're playing. Timeout caused because they were unsure. Some in zone, some in man-to-man. Troutman tries to come over and protect the baseline. A little kiss, finish. But they're such an intelligent team, I don't remember them being that jumbled up, Jake.
No, and Chris Taft needed to be in the middle there.
Coming up next on Big Money, presented by Bud Light, Texas Tech with the daunting task of trying to deal with the Jayhawks of Kansas, who sit atop the Big 12, led by Wayne Simeon, Keith Langford, and the rest of that talented cast. And then at midnight Eastern, it's the classic offense-defense battle. Antoine Hood and the Air Force bring the Mountain West best scoring defense to the court as they take on Danny Granger and the high-scoring New Mexico Lobos.
And now, with the ability to score, they can set up their pressure. First half, they couldn't stick with it. Erratic scoring.
Krauser, they trap him. He got it out of the trap to Ramon. They just do beat the 10 count, and it's Taft all alone for the dunk.
Now that's Roberts' responsibility. He was the 5-man deep. Got to stay at home.
The 5-point lead a moment ago for Syracuse was its largest. McCroskey restores that margin.
A little Louis chance starting, and they've been dying for them to step up.
And perfect. What a nice move to get into the center of that defense.
Pittsburgh handles the press again, and another dunk for Taft off the beautiful feed by Troutman.
How under control for a big guy. That was gorgeous in the delivery.
Well, they're just going over the top and getting two on ones.
Troutman with 14 points, 7 rebounds, now an assist. McNamara missed a three. A three would tie it now for the Panthers.
Troutman loads up early.
Surrounded by Pace and Roberts. Roberts backed off.
There's the kick.
Ramon open off the pass from Graves. A long board out to McCroskey. These are the two best field goal shooting teams in the conference, but not tonight. It's interesting. They're the two top teams in the league in field goal percentage. They're the two worst free throw shooting teams. They can score from the floor, not quite as well from the line. Warwick gets the soft home bounce.
But son, it's not easy to score against either one of them. That's mm-hmm. what makes it tough. The zones are proud. Look at Boeheim. I've not seen him this animated.
Well, he wanted Hakeem Warwick to get back. He doesn't want him pressing in the backcourt to pick up another foul this early in the half.
Boeheim is employing the crowd to get more involved, and they oblige the legendary coach. Graves is open for three.
That's a great job. They're stretching Warwick all the way out top. He can't play the corner. Excellent execution by Pitt.
Pitt back to the 2-3 zone. Krauser on the backside.
Three threes for Graves for 9 points. He had 10 Saturday against Notre Dame. It was 4 of 8 from the floor. McCroskey got away with trying to dribble through a double team, and a foul called. Warg and McNamara, the force for Syracuse. The two orange stars have led them to a two-point lead.
At 7:42 a.m., critical samples arrived at this pharmaceutical lab. At 9:34 a.m., a trade proposal arrived at the National Congress in Brazil. At 10:27 a.m., a birthday present arrived, as promised. Who made all of these things happen? The company that delivers more packages on time than anyone. UPS. What can Brown do for you?
ESPN's Dream Job returns with a new spin.
Welcome back.
As ESPN searches for the next NBA analyst, former NBA players Dana Barros, Gerald Wilkins, J.R. Reed, Matt Bullard, Dee Brown, and Daryl Dawkins are ready to take their shot at the analyst job.
I don't want a real job.
Oh, I lost it.
If these guys are off their game, they won't stay in ours.
Dream Job.
The new season of Dream Job. Live Sunday, February 27th at 10 on ESPN.
Guidance internal. Control program confirmed. 4, 3, 2, 1. All engines running. Liftoff. We have liftoff at 8:14 in the morning.
The first ever G6 from Pontiac. Drive a G6 GT for around $277 a month with smart buy financing. Or get into a new G6 starting around $229. Residency restrictions apply. Call for details. See your local Pontiac dealer.
I want your undivided attention.
I don't want little puny checking.
I want maximum strength checking.
F-R-E-E, free.
Not just free checking, maximum strength checking.
Extended hours, huh?
I'd like to get to a branch without getting on the LIE.
Email alerts that save me money.
I want ATMs uptown, downtown, out of town, everywhere, all over the place.
On every corner, in every borough.
Can you do that for me? I think you can.
Maximum strength checking, only from Chase.
Now they call him Big Dub. Wayne Simeon, a force inside. Can Texas Tech handle him and hand Kansas? This is his first Big 12 loss. That's game two coming up from Lubbock, guys.
And a good one. We look forward to it. You want to answer Chris's question? Can Texas Tech deal with Kansas?
Can they? Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely they can. I think it can Texas.
Giles, they got nice inside people.
Kansas is going to have to guard Texas Tech. That's going to be an issue for them, getting through all those screens. And
some people like to play zone against Knight. Drive you crazy.
Big Monday presented by Bud Light. Pittsburgh and Syracuse, a big one in the Big East. Syracuse trying to remain within a half game of Boston College. They have two losses in conference, BC leading the league with one, and those two teams play Saturday in Chestnut Hill on ESPN.
Big scoring because of this guy. What a solid job McCruskey's provided.
He's been fantastic. 17 points, all the bench points from Syracuse, from McCroskey and Roberts. 17, 18 now for McCroskey. 9 for Roberts. Only 3 points for Pittsburgh off the bench, all from Ramon.
And McCroskey's coached by Oliver Antigua, who's Orlando's brother in high school at St. Raymond. So it'll be a little family squabble over this.
McNamara almost had the steal. McCroskey ripped it away from McCarroll. Held ball. Pittsburgh ball. With Troutman getting a breather. Well, Troutman puts up his numbers. He only plays 29 minutes a game. 15 points and 8 rebounds, and those numbers on the rise for the season in 29 minutes.
I think the protection foul problems, maybe, you know, late in the half, they yank him. He'll be down there at crunch time. Did you say you did the Georgia game when McCarroll went off?
No, I watched it.
Well, yeah,
he had 26 last year. Doris Burke did the game, but it was... Well, he scored more points in that one game than he scored just about in the whole year this year.
One of his other highlights was against Syracuse here last year. He had 15. Foul called, an offensive foul on Gray. Removing screen. Second foul on Gray. That's 18.
Pitt hasn't changed much since the Ben Howland days. Wouldn't you agree?
No,
same type of play, because Jimmy speaks to Ben quite a bit out there at UCLA.
Lockdown defensive team. They bump you, stand you up on your cuts. And Syracuse, if they are strong with the ball, they weren't there. They're going to shoot a lot of free throws down the stretch.
Graves took it away from McNamara, and Krauser is fouled with a chance for three. McNamara, after having the ball taken away, pleading his case that he was fouled, he also fell down trying to run back to catch up to Graves.
Well, he's saying the hand got part of the arm. A good hustle play, but here, this is how you end up hurting a little dive at the second here. Now the floor burns there. He's still upset.
And McCroskey got in Roberts' way when he was going after that shot block.
He might have been able to wipe it away. The three-point play. The foul on Roberts was his third. Syracuse by one midway through the second half.
And McCarroll's got to watch it with Warwick. He's been banging him. The refs have let him know.
And Gray is grabbing Roberts on every opportunity.
And here's the call on McCarroll. So predictable.
I mean, it's been a lot of clutch and grab for Pittsburgh.
First on McCarroll. Ninth team foul, so this will be the last one and one. It'll be shot by Warwick, who's an up and down free throw shooter. He had 12 out of 16 against Villanova as part of his career day Saturday. Rare quiet night lately. He hasn't been quiet for the officials, as usual.
12 for 16. I thought you had a night off there. Valentine's Day, sweet nothings.
I mean, the coaches, particularly Jamie Dixon, he's been quite animated when talkative with these officials tonight. Is it safe to say he's mellowed a little bit over the years, Coach Boeheim?
Absolutely.
No question. I remember when I was a student here, he was a much more animated guy. More regular. He could still get animated, but not as often.
He was here when you were a student? I thought he's only been here 30 years.
This is where they've done a nice job, having Warwick come up. What a catch by Gray.
And that's four on Roberts.
Interesting how many things they will run. Nice pass right to the gut there, and the dump down. What hands by Gray. Good gather and a chance for two.
Awfully close for Terrence Roberts to come away clean with that block.
58% from the line for Gray. He makes the first. He had a nice performance in their win over Syracuse at Pitt. His fourth comes in for Roberts, who's out with the four fouls. Gray had 6 points and four rebounds against the Orange in just 13 minutes.
Played well against Notre Dame the other day, too, with 9 points.
Matching his career high.
And really stepped
in just 15 minutes.
And really stepped in there and did a nice job when Chris Taft was really struggling.
Those free throws, the first points of the night for Gray. Syracuse by one.
Got to get in the cracks here a little bit with the dribble.
McNamara attempted to do just that. McCroskey, a runner, well short, fourth, blocked, and then the foul called by John Cloggerty. A little tardy with the whistle after the players were heading in the other direction.
Against zones, it's a little easier to rebound. Now, you know how important this game is. Nice job by fourth, loading up, and here McCarroll gets on the wrong side, which happens frequently in his zone.
And fourth gets the roll. The foul on McCarroll is second. That's the first point of the night for Craig Forth, the senior from East Greenbush, New York.
The epitome of a student athlete, I might add, too, Sean.
As you would expect at this premier academic institution, a 3.85 grade point average for Craig Forth, academic All-American.
Oh, he's taking it.
Well, Gray looked around for somebody to pass to. Finally realized he was wide open and missed.
His shot is an afterthought. If he would have put it up right away, he probably would have made it.
McNamara bumped by McCarroll. Just a careless foul, the third on Mark McCarroll.
It's a giveaway with this guy, 85% from the free throw line. They worked on that today, the show, and then recover. And, of course, in the back, they've got to zone it up.
McNamara, the all-time leader in free throw shooting in conference games only. 92% and change in Big East games. 87% overall for his career, just a fraction under 88%. And he is the leading Syracuse free throw shooter of all time.
I mean, when he goes to the line, it's kind of like an intentional walk in baseball. It's odd when it goes to the backstop. You know, it never happens.
Give it to him, right? Mark it down. Nice substitute here, I think. Ronald Ramon, because of his ability to drill jump shots against the zone.
Night got out of that double, tapped and missed. Troutman jumped a bit early. McCroskey saves it. Looking for help. They need to get it over and just do with about a second to spare.
Pretty heady play by fourth, though.
McNamara's runner rolls off. And the whistle and a foul called against Pittsburgh. It's on Graves, his second. Well, we saw McNamara spurring on the crowd, and they have responded.
All right, let's knock it out.
Yep.
Okay. Make sure you get that corner. Hey, ice cold Bud Lights at McKinney's.
We could finish this tomorrow, you know. Yeah. Job well done.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now that's freaky.
Fresh, smooth, real Bud Light. It's all here.
One of the reasons we play so well on the road is because we have a team out.
And then what happened?
John Elway drove 98 yards.
She definitely cares about what we eat.
Ooh, Miss McNabb, Miss McNabb.
Al, keep driving.
For away games, she loves giving us Campbell's chunky soup and microwavable bowls. She makes the road feel like home.
Let me hear your battle cry.
Campbell's chunky, it fills you up right.
2.1 seconds left. He throws it down to Leitner.
Leitner grabs it just down.
Fakes left. Shots up.
Leitner, you did it!
Relive your glory days in the Allstate Alumni 3-on-3 Classic. Sign up at allstate3on3.com. That's allstate3on3.com.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Bud Light. Fresh, smooth, real. It's all here. And in part by Mazda, always the soul of a sports car. And Campbell's Chunky Soup, with big chunks of meat and veggies, it fills you up right.
Back in the Sea of Orange, the Carrier Dome in Syracuse, New York. The homestanding Syracuse Orange leading the Pittsburgh Panthers by five. Jerry McNamara turned his ankle in the final seconds of the first half, had it taped, and he's actually played better here in the second half.
No ill effects in the second half. He has been able to plant that foot. He has been quick to the ball, making steals, and going straight up and down. He squares himself so quickly, does his work before he gets into his shot, and that is just pure.
Tough onions. This kid brings it all every game. No question, if he were able to play, he was coming back out.
He had just 5 points in the first half, eight after the ankle was taped. In 12 minutes here in the second half, he's ready to go to the line, but the Panthers are just now coming out of the huddle.
It's not just been his scoring, his playmaking and his floor game has been outstanding.
He has flourished under Boeheim too. I mean, he's a relaxed floor general, can play confidently, gives him a free rein, and some guard, Ernie D comes to mind at Providence. He was one of those guys. Dave Gavitt, you trust the point guard, he's gonna make great decisions for you. You play loose, you play better.
Well, when he was a freshman, I remember Jim Boeheim saying, people have no idea how this kid can score. He talked, oh, he missed a free throw.
He backed all the way off.
Hit the rim.
Yeah, that ball must be defective.
Look at his steal.
And the lay-in.
I thought he was going to try it. He didn't have the bad ankle. He was going to elevate.
Largest lead for Syracuse. 16 points and 9 assists. The assist one shy of the season high, 3 under his career high for McNamara. Taft. Fouled on the drive by fourth.
Just reading that passing lane. Great anticipation. You think he was tempted here, Jay?
Just shooting that gap. And I agree with you. If not for the ankle injury in the first half, he might have gotten up a little closer to the rim.
Squeak.
That's interesting. Pitt's been able to get the ball in the middle, but they haven't been able to get it to somebody who can ring the bell. And that becomes a dilemma. It might not be a bad idea to slide one of the guards in there. Flash, turn, and deliver, or knock it down.
Falling fourth is second. Taft made the first free throw, but not the second. Fourth, the rebound. That foul was the seventh against Syracuse, so it's a bonus situation both ways. Two-three zone from Pittsburgh.
Well, Taft shoots quite a knuckleball, doesn't he? Wakefield would be proud of that one.
It's unfortunate. Got to get a better delivery. They look like they're resting here a little bit and getting a look like this.
Pace, the tip of the McNamara miss, and fourth fouled on the way back up to the rim by Taft.
What an intelligent play by Josh Pace to tip it and control tip it to Craig Forth.
They're a team that does a lot of little things. The beneficiary is fourth there with a very intelligent play by Josh.
Couldn't grab it, kept it alive, and boy, did Josh Pace have a great game against Villanova. 21 points, 7 boards, and 5 assists.
Well, when they get those 3 ringing the bell, McNamara, Warwick, and Pace, that's a very tough lineup.
Whoa. Hit the rim, went up almost to the shot clock and came down through for fourth.
No Cupid doll with that one.
An 8-point lead for Syracuse. 4 fouls for Taft. He is playing with the 4. Troutman given room. Now Krauser with Ramon, Troutman, Taft, and Graves. Good catch by Ramon. Krauser, they need it. They get a big 3.
Big step up by the floor general.
Looks that X over his head for the Bronx, his hometown. Overcame a tough neighborhood. He talked about he could have gone a different direction. Lots of drugs and gangs and violence in his neighborhood, the Bronxdale Project. But basketball, his ticket to a better life. McCroskey. Troutman, the rebound. He goes down to the floor after running into Warwick.
Boeheim exhorting him to get back.
Hit down by 5. Of course, they've been the comeback kings this season. Taft left open, and here come the Panthers again within 3.
But they do have a ticker, though. Taft stepping up big time with that unusual delivery.
And a timeout called by Jim Boeheim. Jamie Dixon left half in to play with the 4 fouls, and he has a big hoop that has the Panthers within 3.
Troutman keeping the ball alive, just thrusts his body into Warwick trying to pick up another foul on the Syracuse star. And in the middle, where you get the ball into that middle of that zone, and you're going to get a good look in Taft knocking it down with that unorthodox release.
You said Wakefield. I would go Hoyt Wilhelm. That's the difference in age.
Negro.
Bill Negro, I can buy too.
Well, tomorrow night it's Super Tuesday presented by Toyota. Connecticut dealing with some injuries and illnesses lately. Rashad Anderson. Marcus Williams played well with strep throat yesterday. Connecticut and Providence, and then Kentucky and South Carolina at 9, the SEC offering.
Well, Jim Calhoun has been busy, unfortunately, visiting his players that have been ill. What a
fourth
screen.
A screen indeed for McNamara. Fourth! Rolls off the screen all the way to the bucket for the dunk.
Craig Steppy, fourth!
Taft is now out of the game for Pittsburgh. Here's Krauser, another three.
You gotta love his ticker. Step it up, seizing the moment in the slot.
He got off to a dreadful shooting start, but he's heating up now. 12 points for Krauser. The lob in for Warwick from McNamara didn't work. Pittsburgh with two to tie and three for the lead.
Nice job by Pace, not fouling. With Krauser hitting this jump shot, the middle has been wide open for these kind of deliveries. Look at that.
And it rolls in for Troutman, and Pittsburgh has come all the way back to tie it at 60.
Well, that shows you something, doesn't it?
Oh, they are just going at each other.
10-3 run for the Panthers.
Fatigue now a problem, I think, with McNamara's injury. Also being comfortable shooting the ball. It takes energy.
McCroskey. Very long with the three. It barely grazed the back rim, but it's last touch by Troutman. So Syracuse will play it in with a fresh 35. Jamie Dixon asking the officials if it touched rim. They said it did, and that's why the shot clock was reset.
Got to move here.
I don't think they knew the referee handed him the ball.
Yeah. Fourth set a great pick earlier. This time he's advertising a little too much.
And a takeaway by Krauser, and then McCroskey ran into him. Krauser will go to the line with a chance to give Pittsburgh the lead. They're back tied up thanks to his long-range heroics and the inside work, as usual, from Troutman.
Our story, children, begins in the County of Kings, Brooklyn, New York, 1963.
Cut from his high school team.
Waking up at 5 every morning to train.
Swish!
And the Tar Heels win the championship.
So he traveled to Chicago because Portland wanted a big man.
Arms pumping up and down as Mr. Elo fell to the ground.
And he lost to the Motor City for the second time.
And he returned to win his first.
His second championship.
This my main man, Money.
Baseball, the press ad.
And he returned to win his fifth.
His sixth championship.
And he returned again for a second time.
And the people said, no, Michael, don't do Michael, it. Michael, you're gonna ruin it.
Don't do it.
But Michael looked at those people and said, I can't accept failure. I can't accept not trying.
And this time, his retirement was final. But don't be sad. It doesn't end there. Because somewhere, someone is practicing.
Who was it?
Who is it?
There are millions surfing the web with net zero for less than $10 a month. Are you one of them? If not, then it's time to switch to the internet service that ranks higher than AOL in customer satisfaction. Join the millions. Switch to net zero. Go to netzero.com.
Coney and Tots. Sonic's got it, others don't. Satisfy your Sonic cravings with our famous extra long cheese Coney, plus a large order of crispy tater tots, made fresh and served up fast, and now only $2.99. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
On DVD.
All I want to do is race.
Man, ain't the guy with the fastest car, just the one who refuses to lose.
ESPN presents 3. With over 5 hours of Dale Earnhardt interviews and races.
Go, boy, go!
Own the 2-disc collector's edition today.
Everyone wants it, basketball's got it. ESPN College Game Day, Saturdays at 11.
Fueled by Mountain Dew.
Rand Lubbock, Ronald Ross, hoping to make it a landmark night for the Red Raiders. They've only beaten Kansas once ever. He's their leading scorer, best three-point shooter. That's coming up next from Lubbock, guys.
All right, Chris, we look forward to that here at the Carrier Dome. One of the fixtures, the Dome Knitter. Like Bill Raftery likes to spin a few yarns during the game.
Without the hair, though, I do.
Take a look at the Nike game track. Pittsburgh with the rebounding edge, but Syracuse has been narrowing that gap. Troutman, what have become standard numbers for him. 17 Pittsburgh turnovers leading to 22 Syracuse points, and the sophomores, McCroskey and Roberts, terrific off the orange bench. And some Pittsburgh fans here.
How'd they get in?
Krauser at the line. Moments ago, Pittsburgh trailed 58-50. Come from 8 down to tie, and now Krauser Missing the front end of the one and one. He runs down the ball in the corner, but he's on the end line.
And Troutman's the one that kept it alive.
And now he is grasping at his lower leg, much the same style we saw McNamara reaching for his leg at the end of the first half.
Maybe that's a good sign for him. It seemed to work well for McNamara in the second half.
He started lighting it up. You're right. Taft in, gives McCarroll a blow. A little more physical play inside.
But Krauser, before he hit those two big threes, was 2 of 12. But he's got guts.
You can't think about it, and he certainly doesn't.
Strong drive by McCroskey, but then he fired up an air ball fielded by Troutman.
Chevy does so many things well. Pounds it here, Befort gets this one, but got it out of trouble with a power dribble.
The rebound gives Troutman a seventh double-double of the season. His fourth is whistled for the foul. His third. 16 points, 10 rebounds for Troutman. Taft at the line. Makes the first one.
Do you buy into the big guys have trouble getting the proper touch on the ball?
No.
Because of the size of the hand. Well, I'm talking to a great shooter.
His hand position is not good on the ball, and he just flicks it. He doesn't really shoot it. You can see it gets into a claw position.
Well, no, I'm not saying him, but big guys in general, like Shaq. And the ball just doesn't fit comfortably.
These two teams, the bottom two in the league, but both above their averages from the free throw line tonight. Pittsburgh's at 71% tonight. Syracuse, 72. They're both in the mid-60s for the year.
And they have stopped McNamara of late. Not doing a good job setting him up. He's got to move a little bit more, I think. That pick outside's not working.
3 minutes to go. McNamara, very long three. Looked like it hit the camera up above the shot clock. Ooh. And it goes out of bounds to Pittsburgh.
Troutman down on that particular play as well. Now McNamara not getting a good look for quite a while. Forced that one just a tad.
5 for 18 from the floor now for McNamara. 3 for 10 from three.
He's always coaching though, isn't he? Mm-hmm. Telling Pace where he'd like him to go. Now that might not be a bad guy to slide into the lane there. Put that little hang jumper up.
And he's also a good passer, so you get to the middle and make a play.
Bill serves the same function for SJ, always telling us where to go, which is very helpful in making our way to the arena.
Clean it up.
Krauser, Taft, Ramon.
Good recovery on him. Such a good shooter.
Taft, middle of the lane, guarded by Ford. He shoveled his feet, no question.
It's a gamble for him to touch it in there. Not as comfortable as others, but as you rotate, Troutman comes up one time, you slide him down, and it looks like they're going to go to Lavon Kendall.
Well, when Taft gets the ball in the center of the floor there, he's got to turn and make a play, turn and look, but his footwork is not great, and he needs to improve his skill level, but he does have a lot of raw ability.
Syracuse, a timeout. Their offense has gone ice cold in this critical game. They are next in action on Saturday at Boston College, and if they would win tonight, they'd have a chance to take over first place with a win in Chestnut Hill against the 9-1 in conference Boston College Eagles. And we're really looking forward to that. What do you think about that ball game coming up on Saturday on ESPN?
Well, it'll be a terrific game. A lot of people, though, think Boston College has got a nice going away present from the Big East with their schedule because they play UConn, Syracuse, Notre Dame, and Pittsburgh only once during the conference season.
Important game for BC in a sense of bouncing back, playing somebody this high level, quality win.
BC is at home against Rutgers on Wednesday before that game, but Syracuse after the BC game, home games against St. John's and Providence, two teams near the bottom or at the bottom of the league before they have the return game at Connecticut. You don't play everybody twice. You only play a couple of opponents twice in the Big East these days, and they've kind of done it based on the powerful teams and the teams that are big on TV all playing each other.
And BC was not rated as the top four or five.
By the way, a lot of Pittsburgh and Syracuse and Connecticut and Notre Dame going at each other twice.
And by the way, Sean, this 2-3 has done a great job. And again, fatigue a factor for McNamara down the stretch.
Warwick's been very quiet. Awkward shot, wouldn't go. Warwick has 10 points in the game. That's half his average. He's been 20 plus in 7 of the last 8. Pitt with the ball up by 1, under 2 minutes to go. Dixon wants a timeout and gets it with 20 to shoot. One timeout left for the Panthers. This is Big Monday presented by Bud Light from the Carrier Dome with more than 24,000 in attendance. The number 9 Orange and the 15th ranked Panthers, Sean McDonough, Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, our producer Bo Garrett, director Mike Schwab, and our outstanding crew. Happy to be the warm-up back for Kansas and Texas Tech coming up at 9:08 Eastern Time. They know the drill. They'll hustle home. They'll watch what should be another excellent game.
Little timeout to get Ramon in the game for the shooting. Interesting little chess match on both ends of the floor. Pitt's played great zone, though. It's really frustrated Syracuse the last 4 or 5 minutes.
And that zone got them back into the game against Syracuse in Pittsburgh 16 days ago after they fell behind 22-5 and came back to win. Down by 8 tonight, and now with the lead, the Panthers with 10 seconds on the shot clock. Taft, middle of the lane. Ramon fires. It was deflected by McNamara.
Well, what a nice recovery by McNamara. When you talk about him being tired, it certainly doesn't show on the defensive end. He plays every possession.
Pace trying to flash there.
Syracuse has gone more than 4 minutes without a point. McNamara, it rattled out.
Wow.
That was halfway down and bounced back out.
Just a little more oomph.
Got to get a point and a half for that. That looked in.
1 minute to go. Pittsburgh trying to shorten the remaining time. Krauser.
Three. Onions. Does he step up when it counts?
And Curtis Shaw has stopped the play, and I'm not sure why.
He's saying there's 47.4 seconds left on the clock.
Wow. You almost knew it would be Krauser. They were stuck. Great understanding of what to deliver, and the defense just a little tardy challenging him.
Boy, in the midst of a dreadful shooting night, he has come out of it when Pittsburgh absolutely needed him to. They did reset the game clock, added about a second and a half.
John, too quick. You want two, you don't have to settle for the three.
It's nearly 5 minutes without scoring a point for Syracuse. Warwick jacks a three. That one rattled out. Fourth there for the putback. Wow, McNamara three. That was halfway in, and Warwick's looked like it got even more of the bucket before it popped back out. Fourth gets them back on the score sheet. His dunk was the last basket at 5:23 remaining. So they went nearly a full 5 minutes before the bucket with 35 seconds to go after another gigantic three by Krauser.
Carl Krauser, not a great shooter, but he hits big shots game after game. That is guts personified.
And a big thing against the zone is get yourself in position to do some damage. Fourth, one of those guys contributes in any way he can, screening, keeping things alive. That time got inside position. Now it gives them a chance to set up their press. It's very important that Roberts not gamble and protect the backcourt.
The green light shooting, the rock tells the story, the difference for Carl Krauser. Syracuse is pressing. Bear in mind, Pittsburgh's not a very good free throw shooting team. They'd like to get in the hands of Krauser if they can. Graves, Kendall.
They gotta use their head and give it.
They're trying to, and Roberts fouls Troutman, who falls down.
Fortunately, before he got near us.
And they get a foul from Roberts, and that's his fifth. They wanted a foul by anybody else but Roberts.
They did a great job in the pressure in the backcourt. Didn't come up with something, then they couldn't get and identify people to give it up.
But it took a long time to foul, and you wonder even what they were talking about in the timeout. They had chances.
Well, I think once they beat the timeline, the floor was spread pretty much. Mm-hmm. They couldn't recover and get in contact with their respective guy.
Kansas and Texas Tech scheduled to get underway in about 4 minutes. We'll send you right out there to Lubbock when we're finished here in Syracuse. So Troutman 71% for the year from the line and has had a good night there tonight. 12 of 16 from the free throw line. Will be at the stripe when play resumes, 18.6 to go. And each team with one timeout left. It will be a two-shot opportunity for Troutman.
And Sean, I think even if he makes both, push it up the floor, go for the two, get uneven numbers, get the press started, try for one trap, maybe a second, and then give the foul.
Pittsburgh tonight, 71% from the line. Better than their season average of 66%. Put his finger up to his lips just to say the crowd quiet, and they are quiet after that one. We mentioned earlier all that he's been through in his life. This doesn't seem like that tough a circumstance. 16-4 run for the Panthers. The lead is 4, two-possession game, unless they foul a three-point shooter.
Nice look.
Warwick with dunk. Timeout Syracuse off the pass from McNamara. Warwick the score to get Syracuse within two with 12.8 to go.
Sean, that shouldn't have happened that easily. Nobody got back for Pitt. Gave the wide open look underneath.
Well, these two teams in recent years have played some dandies. 2 years ago, Syracuse hosted then number two Pittsburgh. Arizona was number one. They had lost earlier in the day, so Pittsburgh looking at being number one for the first time in the history of their program. Final seconds of the game. Jeremy McNeil followed the McNamara miss. Then with 0.8 seconds left, Brandon Knight, the bomb. It goes in, but it was after the buzzer. The fans stormed the court for the second time. They thought it was over seconds ago. Before that, stormed the court, cleared the court, and then Knight shot after the buzzer. Will we have similar buzzer beater heroics? What do you look for in the last 13?
Well, when the ball is inbounded, you want to try to get the steal off the pass if you can in the quick trap. Otherwise, they've got a foul as soon as possible.
You go for one, maybe one good trap, and maybe one rotation and gamble on the pass maybe at the most. But they've done the right thing. Get the two, see what they can do on the defensive end, make them force them to make the free throws.
And you can be aggressive in the trap and aggressive in going after the steal, because if you foul, you're still in good shape. There's still time.
And ideally, 5-second call with Warwick on the ball is what you'd love to get. As they put him back this time, though, and they're actually playing smaller.
Syracuse has won all of its close games on their way to the 22-3 overall record.
And Jamie counters with a lot of little guys because of their free throw shooting ability and their speed to get free.
Graves throwing the deep pass for Troutman, and Warwick fouls him.
Pretty clever, huh? Mm-hmm. A little step and go, trusting Troutman. Which brings to mind the tight end capability. See him in the open floor?
1 year of football in high school. There are some who think he could be a tight end in the National Football League. Boy, he's been huge at the line. 14 out of 18. He makes two here. It would really be tough on the prayerful Syracuse fans. That one bounced around and stayed in.
Bends the knees as we've seen all through his career and follows through. Same drill.
This one could be the dagger. And there's still 12 seconds to go. Clutch again and again. Siobhan Troutman.
For Pittsburgh, no fouls and no threes.
They are picking up in the backcourt, trying to make Syracuse eat some clock here. Edel in the handoff to McNamara. He lets one fly from deep range. They really didn't need that. Krauser the rebound, and Pittsburgh is going to post a big victory on the road. They sweep Syracuse for just the third time in the history of their rivalry in the Big East. They did it 2 years ago, and they did it back in the late 80s when they had Jerome Lane and Charles Smith and Sean Miller. Final score, Pittsburgh 68, Syracuse 64. Coming up next, second-ranked Kansas against Texas Tech. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. Now for Bill Raftery and Jay Billis, our entire crew, Sean McDonough saying, good night from Syracuse. Let's send you to Ron Franklin in Lubbock, Texas.